Hi dear students, in last class we have discussed about the what are the qualitative characteristics of accounting. So today this is the last topic of the first chapter, that is the role of accounting and what are the basic terms which are to be used in accounting. Okay, so role of accounting in every business organization, we can say that accounting plays a very important role. Why? Because it helps to know the financial position of the business organization. We are going to maintain the financial transactions in a books of account, it is easy to identify the what is the exact position of the financier. That helps to take the decisions for a future and to earn the profit, how to earn the profit in the business organization, which is more helpful and which is benefited to the business organization. So we can say that role of accounting is very important in the every business organization. So how the role of accounting plays in business organization, how it helps, means there are four important points which are to be related for the role of accounting. So here you can say, first one, that is assisting management and combined study, substitute of memory, information to end users. So these are the four important points of role of accounting. Here we can say assisting management is nothing but what, when you are going to maintain the financial records in the business organization, it is more helpful to the managers. Why? Because they can analyze the transactions or they can analyze the records which are to be maintained in the books of accounts, which is to be helpful to manage all the things related to financial resources. So on that basis we can say it is more helpful to assist the management, which is helpful for the business organization. Okay, so it can be help to manage the finance, how to control the finance cost when there is a having more expenditures in the organization, how it could be controlled with the help of financial statements. We can, with the help of accounting the records, we can manage the financial resources. Okay, so next one is comparative study. Here we can say comparative study is one of the role of accounting. Why? Because it is helpful to compare the financial statements from previous year to current year. We can compare the financial statements with the help of previous year data. Whatever the information or whatever transactions are going to record in the books of account, previous year how it happens, what is the position of the financial condition in the last year or previous year, that should be compared with the present year. Now we can say it as a current year, which is more helpful to take the decision for the future year. Means comparing the financial position of the previous year with the current year, which is more helpful for the future days to take the decisions. Overall we can say that it is more helpful to take the decisions related to financial position. So on that basis we can say it is helpful to take the study about the comparison of previous year with the current year financial position. Okay, next, that is a substitute of memory. Here we can say in every organization there will be the human beings which cannot, which is not able to record or remember all the transactions in the financial, whatever it may be made in the organization, but it is more helpful with the help of recording the transactions in the books of entry. So we can say it is impossible to remember all the transactions or whatever the activities have to be done in the organization. It is impossible to remember all the activities for a human being. So on that basis we are going to record it in the books of accounts. So we can say that it is more helpful to recognize whatever the transactions are to be made in the organization, which is helpful with the help of, which is helpful to study about the finance. Okay, so that we can say substitute of memory. Next, that is the information to end users. End users are nothing but these are the persons who are going to invest, make investment in your business. So when you are going to give the information related to your financial position, then after receiving the information, they are interested to invest a capital amount in your business. So on that basis you are doing, or you are providing the financial statements to the users to make the investment to increase the capital amount of your business. So it is more helpful to the organization. So these are the four important role of accounting, that it helps to the managers to manage the financial position in the organization, and it is helps to compare the financial position from previous year to current year to take the decisions, and it is helpful to store the memory, which is not impossible to record the transactions orally. Then it is helpful with the help of maintaining the financial statements, and accounting can be useful by providing the information of the financial position to the users. Why? Because to make the investment in your business. So these are the four important role of accounting. So we can say that accounting plays a very important role in every business organization.
Which we cannot see and touch, that are the intangible assets. Later on, we are going to
So what it says? So asset. There are fixed assets and current assets. Next, liability. Opposite of assets, that is a liability. Liability is nothing but all you have to pay, make expenses in your business. That is called as a liability. So here, long term liability and short term liability. Two liabilities are there. One is long term liability and the one is short term liability. Liability is nothing but all whatever the expenses you are going to make in your business for the long term is nothing but all after or more than 1 year or more than 1 year we can say it as a long term liability. Within a year we can say it as a short term liability. So liability is nothing but all it is one of the responsibility you are going to take in your business organization, that we can say as a responsibility which is to be taken in the business organization is called as the liability. Means you have to make the expenses, you have to take the risk, you have to make the payments for the whatever the activities have to be done in the business organization. That is called as the liability, long term liability and short term liability. Which we are having the availability of more than 1 year, that is called as the long term liability. If there is having a short period of time to pay the amount, that is called as the short term liability. Okay. So next, that is the capital. Capital is the amount which is to be invested in the business organization. It is the first step when I am going to start the business. Means when I am going to start the business, we have to put the certain amount as an investment. That is called as the capital amount. Okay, investment amount is called as the capital amount when it should be, it is taken means when you, the business is to be initiated, when the business is to be commenced. In that moment, you are going to invest the amount. That invested amount is called as the capital amount of the business organization. Okay, next that is the sales. Sales is nothing but when I am going to produce products have to be sold. That is called as the sales. There are two types of sales are there. One is cash sales and credit sales. If you are going to sell the product by cash, or when you are receiving the cash, when selling the product, that is called as the cash sales. If you are giving the on credit basis, if you are providing the product on credit basis, that is called as the credit sales. Okay. So next one is the revenue. Revenue also called as the income. Income in the sense what? When you are going to invest the amount in the business, if you are getting the income from that, that is called as the revenue. Okay, so revenue in the sense is nothing but income. Okay, so next that is expenses. Expenses is nothing but whatever the cost arises to earn profit in your business. Okay, or to earn income in your business, that is called as the expenses. Expenses is nothing but whatever the cost incurred in your business to earn income or earn revenue in your business organization, by your business organization, that is called as the expenses. Cost incurred. For example, we can say paying rent or wages. When you are going to give the wages for your employees or for your building rent or any other commissions to the other persons, that expenses, that cost is called as the expenses. Okay. Next, expenditure. Expenses and expenditure both are different. Why? Because here you can say cost incurred for the purpose of earning revenue. Here you can say expenditures which is benefited for your business organization. Why you are going to make expenditure? There are two types of expenditures are there. One is revenue expenditure and another one is capital expenditure. Here you can say this expenditure are to be made with the help of some of the events. Why? Because when there will be the more expenses. When you are going to give the salary, it is also one type of expenditure. When it is a expenses, that we can say it as a revenue. Here we can say as a expenses arises, that is called as the revenue expenditure. When we are going to do the expenditure for to earn more asset, that with the help of asset we are going to expenditure means it is called as the capital. Understood? Expenditure is nothing but all. It is also one type of expense only. But how type of which type of expense it is? When you are going to make the expenditure to get the benefit from the expenses, that is called as the revenue expenditure. Or if you are going to make the expenditure, it is then it is benefited from the assets to get the benefit of the assets, that is called as the capital expenditure. Expenditure is to be made. Why? Because for to get the other sources income, that is called as the expenditure. So one type of expenditure, that is if the expenses are more, that is called as the revenue expenditure. If expenditure are made to take the return from the asset, that is called as the capital expenditure. Okay, this is about the expenditure. Next we can say as a profit. Profit is nothing but it is also a type of income only, but we cannot say it as an income. Why? Because profit is to earn on the excess of revenue. Why? Whatever you are says that revenue means income. Income is nothing but what? When you are going to make an investment in a business, you are going to earn the income. Okay. Profit is nothing but what? Excess of revenue. More than revenue, whatever you get to, that is called as a profit. Minimum amount which we are receiving, that is called as the income. Excess of income is called as the profit. More than revenue, it is there, is that amount is called as the profit. Minimum amount is called as the revenue. Excess revenue is called as the excess from revenue is called as the profit. Okay. Next one, that is gain. Gain is also called as the income. Why? Because gain is nothing but we can say it as a profit from events. Here we can say profit from events means events like it may be from the appreciation of the assets. For example, we can say it as an appreciation of the assets or interest on the capital amount. That is called as the gain. Excess amount which is to be provided from the profit is called as the gain. Profit is nothing but excess amount which is provided from the revenue is called as a profit. Gain is nothing but excess amount which is to be provided with the help of profit is called as the gain. Or again, we can say as a with the help of events. Events are nothing but for example, assets. With the help of assets, you are going to get the profit, that is called as the gain. For example, we can say it as a appreciation of assets. Appreciation is nothing but when the asset value is to be increased. That is called as the appreciation. For example, we can say, we can take as a building. This year building cost is rupees 10 lakh. After 5 years, it should be increased. So that increasing asset value is called as the appreciation. On that basis, if you are getting the profit, that is called as the gain. Okay? If the asset value is increased, that is called as the appreciation. So appreciation amount which is to be benefited to the organization, that is called as the gain. Okay? Next, that is the loss. Loss is nothing but opposite of profit. Why? Because loss is when you are going to get the loss in your business. If your business is not running in a good way or if you are not earning a profit, then it is called as the loss. Next, that is the discount. Discount is nothing but what? If you are giving the, deducting the value in your product. If you are providing the discount or if you are reducing the value of your product, that is called as the discount. Okay, deduction in the value of product is called as the discount. Next, that is voucher. Voucher is one of the document. Voucher is nothing but not one of the document which is to be used in a business organization. This document is says as a evidence. We are going to maintain the recording the books of transactions in a particular book. When you are going to recording the transactions, for that transactions you have to maintain the vouchers or you have to maintain the documents. Why? Because it should be evidence. How you are going to record the transactions with the help of evidence, which is called as a document, says as voucher. So this is one of the evidence document. Okay, here we can say as a evidence document. Why? Because to maintain the transactions in the books of account. So voucher is one of the receipt we can say. When you are going to, for example, we can say that when you are going to purchase some product or some any asset. When by purchasing the asset, they will, you are paying the amount or cash. When you are after paying the amount, they will give the receipt. That receipt is called as the voucher. That is the document we can say in the accounting system. Okay, voucher is one of the accounting document which is helpful for your evidence to record the transactions in books of account. Next, that is goods. Goods are nothing but products. Goods are nothing but products which are to be used in a business organization. Whatever the products are to be sold or purchased, that is called as the goods. Okay. Next, that is the drawings. Drawings is nothing but what? Withdrawing the amount from your capital amount. Capital amount is nothing but investment amount in your business. Okay. When you are going to invest in your business, for example, you are going to start a business by investing the capital amount of rupees 10 lakh. Okay. So after investing the capital amount as 10 lakh rupees in your business, after some years, after 2-3 years, you are going to withdrawing the amount for your personal use or for your business purpose. When you are going to withdrawing that amount, that is called as the drawings. Withdraw amount is called as the drawings. It may be for your personal use or it may be for the business purpose. Okay. Next one, that is purchase. Purchase is the opposite of what? Sales. Sales is nothing but you are going to sell the product from business. Purchase is nothing but you are going to purchase the products through your business. There are two types of purchase are there. One is cash purchase and credit purchase. If you are going to purchase by paying the cash, that is called as the cash purchase. Or if you are going to purchase a product on credit basis, means now you are going to purchase the product, after sometimes you are going to pay the cash, that is called as the credit purchase. Cash purchase and credit purchase. Next one is stock. Stock is also called as the inventory. Stock is nothing but the products which are to be unsold. Still they are not sold by your business. The stock materials, unsold products are called as the stock. In simple words, we can say it as a unsold products or unsold goods are called as the stock. Next, debtors. Debtors are nothing but debtors are the persons we can also call as the customers. Debtors are nothing but customers who are going to purchase goods from your business. That persons are called as the debtors. In other words, we can say that who are going to pay the amount for your business, to your business, that is, they are called as the debtors. Creditors are nothing but are owners of the company who are going to receiving that amount by the customers. That persons are called as the creditors. So these are the important basic terms of accounting. Okay, so ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ, ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಶಬ್ದಗಳ ಮಾಹಿತಿಯನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಸಂಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಎಂಟಿಟಿ. ಎಂಟಿಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಯಾವಾಗ ನೀವು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತಿರಲ್ಲ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡಿದಂತ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಫರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಒಂದು ಸಂಘಟನೆ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಆ ಸಂಘಟನೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ ಎಂಟಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಒಂದು ಗುಂಪು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಎಂಟಿಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಗುಂಪು. ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್, ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ವಹಿವಾಟು ನಡೀತಾ ಇದಾವೆ. ವಹಿವಾಟು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಕೊಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡೋದು. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ರೀತಿ ಇದಾವೆ, ಒಂದು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್. ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಹಣವನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕುದುರೆ ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ತಗೊಂಡಂತ ವಸ್ತುಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಸೆಟ್. ಅಸೆಟ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ರೀತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಸೆಟ್, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಟ್. ಅಸೆಟ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ರೀತಿ ಒಂದು ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗೆ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಲಾಭದಾಯಕ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ನಾವು, ಯಾಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಇದರಿಂದ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಲಾಭ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಅಸೆಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಅಂತಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ವಸ್ತುಗಳು ನಮಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ರೀತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಇಂಟ್ಯಾಂಜಿಬಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ಟ್ಯಾಂಜಿಬಲ್ ಅಂತ. ಟ್ಯಾಂಜಿಬಲ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಸ್ತುಗಳು, ಇಂಟ್ಯಾಂಜಿಬಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಸ್ತುಗಳು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್, ಮಷಿನರಿ, ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ಸ್, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಏನಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಲ್ಸ್ ರಿಸೀವೇಬಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಅವುಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಲ್ಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಲ್ಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಹೊಣೆಗಾರಿಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಹೊಣೆಗಾರಿಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೋಗ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಸ್ಕ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ನಾವು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಂದ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಹಣಕಾಸಿನ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ, ಲ್ಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಏನಂತೆ, ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಮತ್ತು ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಲ್ಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಅವಧಿಯನ್ನು ಒದಗಿಸಿಕೊಡ್ತು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಬಿಫೋರ್ 1 ಇಯರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆನೆ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಹೊಣೆಗಾರಿಕೆ ಅವಧಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್, ಬಂಡವಾಳ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಹೂಡಿಕೆ ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಒಂದು ಹಣ ಹಣಕಾಸಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ ಬಂಡವಾಳದ ಹಣ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅದಾದ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್, ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡುವುದು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತು ನೀವು ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಾವು ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ವಸ್ತು ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಾವು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಕುದುರೆ ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಏನಾದರೂ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ನ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ಕಮ್, ಲಾಭ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತು ನಾವು ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಬಂದಂಥ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು. ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ, ಒಂದು ವ್ಯವಹಾರದ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹಣವನ್ನು ಗಳಿಕೆ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು, ವೆಚ್ಚ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಇಲ್ಲೇನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ವೆಚ್ಚ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಒಂದು ಲಾಭ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ಗೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನೀವು ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಗಳಿಸಿದ್ದಿರಲ್ಲ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನೀವು ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಗಳಿಸಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ವೆಚ್ಚಗಳು ಆಗ್ತವೆ, ಆ ವೆಚ್ಚಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ನೀವಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಅಂದರೆ ಬಾಡಿಗೆ, ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೆ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ಪಗಾರ ಅಂದರೆ ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ವೇಜಸ್ ಕೂಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಂಥವಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಒಂದು ಎರಡು ರೀತಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತವೆ, ಒಂದು ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ವಸ್ತುಗಳ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನೀವು ಏನಾದರೂ ಪಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು, ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಪಡಿಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವೆಚ್ಚ ಏನಿರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಯಿತು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಬಂದಂಥ ಲಾಭಿಗೆ ನಾವು ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅಸೆಟ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಬಂದಂಥ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಂಡಿಚರ್ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ Next one, profit. Profit under the income of the Mundina and step on the body. Leaving out income for the day, it keeps the H in a matter, income keeps the H in a matter in another season, another time of the day, profit under the day, excess from revenue under the day. Excess of revenue under it keeps the H in a matter with the country, the Mukanda Pananda, income source in the other time of the day, profit under the day. Gain under the profit from events. What's the word of Mukanda? Bananda, Lava, I mean, the three gain under the day. If you have the example of Rebecca, really appreciation of assets in the day. Appreciation of the Yavaka on the asset will be Hachagatala, other than my appreciation of the creativity. It takes humble in another day on the building. He was the building of Hatlaksha for 200 days, and then he was 4-5 years after the rate and everything but the shy. So, in another rate of increase, I think. Other than I mean, I do lava, other than I mean, appreciation of the creativity. Other Mukandra, events from Mukandra, Bandanda, lava, I mean, gain of the creativity. Okay, next go to loss. Loss is name of company, Saria, the run out the land. Profit earn agagilla. So profit earn agagilla and the loss of the theory. Amen, discount. Discount under the AI theory. You put on the products and Marata Madua, discount Madri, Athwa, the Belena, Kadita Madinandra, discount Agate. Amen, watch her under the document. On the receipt of the theory. Yaga was going to be purchased money, it was sale money. You Madaga, our Portaka, the receipt again in the Ladu, document of the theory, or the evidence again of the news Agate. Okay, next goods. Select goods on the other. Goods under products. We may Marata Marta, the Concord, I was calling an animatively, select a good on the other. Another animal was to be goods under the same. Other next drawings. Other drawings on the right. We invest money in the capital amount. Mandavada, the other new members, at the organization in the Vectigolo, a Hanavana, withdraw the country. The one day, other than the drawings under. Personal use आएगे वो तो अतः business purpose आएगे वो ये तो कलर withdraw मार्क कौन बोला था कहीं पर तभी drawings में करेंगे आधा अंदर purchase अंदर ना कौन कोड़ों बन चुके इलेवन मार्किंग ना sales अंदर ना हमें ना वस्तु ना मारा टा मार्ट देंगे इलेवन अगर तो purchase चले पैर कर दे वस्तु ना नाउ purchase मार्क को देंगे organization में अभी पढ़े ये डिंग देते हैं ना तो cash purchase इन्हें तो credit purchase cash purchase अंदर ये वस्तु खरीदी मार्क कौन डाला cash अंदर इन्हें तो purchase मार्क दे cash ना कोट तो वस्तु ना खरीदी मार्क कौन रहे ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ನೀವು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ದಿನಗಳ ನಂತರ ನಾವು ಏನಾದರೂ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಈ ವಸ್ತು ಅಷ್ಟನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡು ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅರ್ಧ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇನ್ನರ್ಧ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಉಳಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಂತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಿ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರಿ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಇನ್ನೂ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ವಸ್ತುಗಳು ಏನಾದರೂ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಉಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ವು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅನ್ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅನ್ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತಾನೆ ಉಳ್ಕೊಂಡಂತ ವಸ್ತುಗಳಿಗೆ ಸರಕುಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಶುದ್ಧ ಏನು ಇನ್ವೆಂಟರಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಡೇಟಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ಗ್ರಾಹಕರು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ವಸ್ತು ಯಾರು ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯರ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಗ್ರಾಹಕರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಡೇಟಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರು ಕಂಪ್ನಿಯವರಿಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯಾವ ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇಷ್ಟು ವಸ್ತುಗಳು ಏನು ಬರ್ತವೆ ಸೊ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ So today we have studied the role of accounting and basic terms in accounting. Okay? This is the completion of your first chapter. Thank you.